when I just went into NS, 18, right? She's in primary 3.
Think about it. Let that sink in.
Hi, I'm Elaine and I'm 29 this year.
Hi, I'm Angelo and I'm 22 this year. We've been together for 2+ years and we have an age gap of 7 years.
I'm John, I'm 30 this year.
Hi, I'm Breanna, I'm turning 21 this year.
We've been together for 2 months.
And our age gap is 9 years.
Hi, my name is Gracie and I'm 20.
Hi, my name is Brendan, I'm 27 this year and we've been dating for 2 years.
And we have a 7 years age gap.
We met here at DSL.
How we came to know each other was through InstaWalk. I noticed everyone there had like a job scope except this girl. Then I say, oh, you seem very busy. I say, yeah, I need to take care of all the bag. What if people come steal, you know?
I found me like, this is, you can't concentrate on shooting, you know? Why you keep coming and talk to me?
I don't need.
You got one thing I killed already.
You told me when I first came out of the bus, then you're like, wow.
I think you're dreaming, bro.
Actually, we met on Bumble.
I did not know what to expect because I don't know if he will be like the same like persona as like in videos or whatever. Yeah, he's exactly the same, even noisier in real life.
When I do online dating, right, I don't like restrict the age limit at all. My only like sort of like caution, what if like she responds like an overzealous fan, you know, through the texting phase, right? As much as there's like those XMM elements, right? She was still like kind of like mature in some of the things that we talk about, and like we kind of vibe off each other's weird energy quite well.
We first met during a director list ceremony at our school. Me and my friends were just sitting at the very top row. Suddenly the door opens up and there's this spotlight casting on her, you know. So she nearly caught my attention.
Oh my god, so traumatic.
It's not traumatic. You like stood out amongst the crowd.
They asked us to take like a group photo and all. And I actually stood next to him.
My heart was like, so I actually got my friend to find her Instagram.
Even your lecturer helped you also, right?
Yeah. I proceed to DM her.
Because I'm an artist also, she tried to ask me to do a commission of his mom. And that's where the conversation continued.
It wasn't until like maybe 2-3 months later before we started to like get close to each other. Then there was a night where we went drinking with like a friend of ours. We played like 5-10, all this kind of thing. That's when like I started to like eye her a bit lah.
Yeah. That was also the moment I realized like kind of felt a thing. Because like, I remember I was pouring the drink and then like it spilled over my hand. And then I think you pull out your shirt and then you just wet for me. Then I just look at him like.
After we all swipe right, I think it was like maybe 2 weeks. Yeah, then I chill her out. Because we both love Animal Crossing. We decided to go to the
Lee Kong Chian
Natural History Museum. But we went there, then we just point at animals and then mispronounced some names and then ha ha ha. And then after that we went to National Gallery where I planned like a mini personalized art jam session. And then after that we went for Korean and we hang out. It doesn't feel like there's an age gap. In terms of maturity levels, she is high for her age and I am low for my age. So we kind of met in the middle.
We both can just switch up. So in any scenario where we both need each other to be like more mature or like to just talk things out, we both can just step up to fill that role. Yeah.
Yeah, and then we got together last year, December.
Since we studied the same school, we basically meet each other every day.
One day after class ended and all that, we were going home. Then he reached out his hand like that. Instead of giving him my bag, I decided to like just play with him only. I put my hand there instead. And then
I grabbed it.
Yeah, I was so shocked. I was like, wait, this was not how I imagined it to go. What? Yeah.
Yeah, that was the intent. And I did.
So we ended up walking all the way to the bus stop, holding hands. And I was like, halfway through, I was like, okay, wait, what's going on? And then he was like, isn't it obvious enough?
You have to understand that we took very long before we even got into a relationship. So we've been dating for 2 years, but we've actually been officially together for a year only. During that period, she ended things with me like 8 times. Each and every time, like I show up to her doorstep, like I fought for it. But there were times where I wanted to give up and there were times where she also wanted to give up. I made a scrapbook, made a video. Alama. Then after that, end up you just on the bed, just, you want to be my boyfriend lah. Okay lah.
Okay lah, I mean back then really was a bitch lah. If we turn back time, I would still I'm sorry, I still do the same because like I think at the point of time I couldn't understand how this thing would work out. When I was talking to my friend about this problem, I also brought up the fact that 7 years might not be the issue, but it's more of life stages that he haven't
experienced. And I didn't blame her as well. Like I knew where she stood. I was a 20-year-old. I had only one long-term relationship prior to this. She had concerns that I would get into a lot of new environments, like maybe school or other working environments, where I would meet a lot of new people. But my stance was, I can't live with a what if, you know?
Because of the age gap, so there were some like maturity differences. Because of her past relationships, she's a bit insecure.
Mm.
So I often had to try to talk to her.
But overall, I think in terms of maturity level, he's also the one that helps me grow all this while. It also meant that he gave me a lot more guidance in terms of life choices and yeah.
My friends, I only one girl was like,
why are you into older guys? Why are you so old?
My other friends weren't like, wow, he's 9 years old. They're like, they're more like, oh my god, it's John. Like that kind of thing, you know.
I guess my online persona helped out. So y'all better go and like, share and subscribe. Because I'm full of shit, right? So like, we could still connect quite well.
We don't really feel the age in our relationship at all. It's fun lah when our friends find out.
Yeah.
Like, she will come meet my friends. My friends will call her auntie.
Yeah, they call me auntie.
Friends, I think they were quite supportive because he's handsome.
I mean, my friend is the one that got her Instagram, so yeah. They were very supportive.
There was no big hoo-ha, but it was always met with a, huh? How old is he? But then a lot of them don't believe me when I say he's 27.
For me personally, in my circle, I think only got people make casual jokes. They were not against whatever was happening.
For his friends, they're quite fun, but like, obviously they're a bit like older, then like some things a bit...
I'll just quote what she say lah, yeah. She just say that they're uncle.
I never!
And then I asked really, I'm quite uncle, then I was like, then she was like, yeah uncle. Then I was like, so am I uncle? Then she said, no, you're fine.
Yeah, you're spinning this a different...
One of them was already a father. So the child very small, then she go and play with the toddler. Then they say, hey, must carry the baby, must support the neck, because babies cannot support the neck, right? So they ask me when she drink, hey, if she drink too much, I need to support her neck.
I mean, most of my friends is just what I felt like. How come you can date someone 7 years? Like, you sure or not?
It was very scary for me at first to like go out and meet her friends, because like, in my head, the friends already have a certain impression of me, which is this young boy who knows nothing. We ended up clicking also lah, so all was good.
So the first time he met my parents,
it was during Christmas.
Yeah. Actually, I was quite shocked about their reaction though. I thought they were gonna be like, oh, so this is the guy. It felt more like a meet the parents session for some reason. Like, he just went up to him and like shook his hand and it like felt like, what? What's going on?
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the normal thing to do. What? My hands was like, you know, like a bit shaking. For me, my mom was like, huh? At that point, you were like, what, 17?
Yeah, actually, that was quite small.
Very early on in our relationship, I kept pestering her that she tells her family, have them acknowledge about our age gap. Because I think even if it's not important to us, right, it may be important to other people.
You told me that if my father was outside smoking, tonight will be the night where you must tell him. Lo and behold, he was outside. What do you think about John? And then he was like, oh, okay, I think it's fine. And I was like, oh, do you know how old he is? I expected him to know. Then he was like, no, I don't know. And I was like, shit. He's Coco's age. And then he was like, oh. And I was like, do you have any opinions about that? And then he was like, no, I think it's fine. Oh, thank you. Goodbye, good night.
My parents love the fact that she's like a working adult, because like when we go to my place, my mom and Elaine will start complaining to each other about work. Yeah, like aunties lah, legit like aunties lah. Okay, her dad has seen me a few times before we were officially introduced.
I think now it's more of them trying to impress each other. Like, he'll go and learn some Chinese words and then try to like talk to my dad in Mandarin, and then my dad will try to like reply him in English. So it's like quite cute.
I would say like intimacy.
I mean, it's the personality that matters more to me rather than the age itself. Really just trust law.
There's no secret, it's just communication.
Yeah.
Both parties must be willing to communicate and then must also understand. If not, like, if you don't understand, there's no point communicating, actually.
So whenever I was feeling doubts or anything, I always make sure to tell him, and he always make sure that I won't go to sleep angry whenever we have a fight.
I guess it's to just keep communication open, make sure your partner is actually listening to you and not like ignoring your issues or belittling them, this and that.
Yeah, and I think like as with any good relationship, it doesn't matter what kind of age gap. What matters is like the dynamic of the relationship must be like one that makes both parties feel secure.
Thank you guys for watching this episode.
If you like this video, leave a comment.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Bye!